morning, friends. I am again in my again live with accounting process, and this is basically the concluding part, nearly concluding part for the concluding part of accounting process. I have told you a lot with regards to this, and I have already presented 13 classes for you. Today I am going to take up the final accounts in full. What is in full? What I have done so far, if recollect well, try to recollect, I think it is, your memory is quite good. And I initially, in my first class, I told you accounting is a process. Process means a set of functions. And accounting process is concerned with preparation of account. And what is account? Account is a statement of event, I told you. But for the students of commerce and accounts, the account is a statement of the transactions. Now, how we get the transaction, the results, total results of the transaction, and that is the original account which I do need. The process of accounting starts with the occurrence of any event, and events are analyzed, and those events which are of our interest, that would be taken into consideration by the accountant. And what is our events? Our events are transactions. So identification of transaction is the first function of in the process of accounting. Then we go on putting it in black and white, that is in recording. The recording part has got two aspects. One is recording daily, book of prime entry, book of original entry, that is journal, and from there they are recorded in the ledger, a set of books, set of different pages, each and every page is entitled to a particular account, particular item, and from journal we record in the ledger, that is posting, then costing and balancing. After balancing, we get a good number of ledger account balances. Some are debit, some are credit, and total debit and total credit are tallied, and we get the result. What is the result? Both the, as we know, total debit must be equal to total credit, total debit balances must be equal to the total credit balances. And if it is agreed, we are happy. And we are confident that there has been no arithmetical error. So we have got a summarized form of all the account, all the transactions are recorded. Now, from this, what is our objective? The objective of accounting is accounting for what? Accounting for business. Business for what? Business for profit. Okay. Now you see one thing I am writing here. The business. Business is for profit. It's for profit. Now accounting, the task of accounting is the ascertainment of profit. So it is the profit, it is the ascertainment of profit that is our basic objective. But the immediate objective of accounting is to find out the net surplus I have generated, or the business house has generated during a particular period concerned. And that we do by the preparation of final accounts. Final accounts, what are final accounts? Final accounts are those which give us the final results of the transaction during a particular period concerned. Okay, in fact, I have already told you the final result only comes at the time of the death of any organization. So you have started any organization 10 years back, and it is going to be stopped. Okay, your function activities are going to stop at the end of this year. Now you can ascertain what is the total income, what is the total surplus you generated, or what are the deficiencies you have made during the last period. But business is a business house, is a going on concept. So I have told you there is no maturity date, there is no last date. So we think it is a going on concern, it is a continuity. This is known as the continuity concept of accounting. The continuity accounting concept of accounting says that each and every organization is a going on concern and it goes on continuing. So what we do, how to find out our profit? We find out our profit for a particular period. That period may be 3 months, that period may be of 6 months, that period may be of a year, maybe a year, and a year. Basically, our practice is to prepare the account for a particular period. Yeah. And the period for which accounts are period, that is known as accounting period. Or if it is year, the year, it is known as accounting year. Within this accounting year, we have effected good number of transactions. Okay? So there is a span. There is a span of 12 months. There is a span of 12 months. During these 12 months, we have effected huge number of transactions. These transactions, some transactions have generated funds, some transactions have led to the depletion of funds. Ultimate result is that. So net income, what is the net income? This is the first category. Then what is the net outflow? That is net flow positive and net flow negative. And this difference is basically regarded as the surplus generated. And in order to do that, what do? We prepare the final account. Okay. The final account, there are two types of organization. One is trading organization and other one is non-trading organization. Trading organizations are those which are engaged in earning profit. All the trading house, all the industrial house are there. But accounts are also kept by all organizations, those who are not interested to earn profit, but still they are meeting the transactions, they are expanding, they are earning something. Such consider the example of a club, the library, or hospital, or whatever it may be. All are meeting expenses. All are generating some amount of fund. So they are known as non-profit seeking concern. So final accounts, I will give you the detailed picture of final accounts of total concern. And one part of the final account is that account which gives the final result. And if the results are results of a trading concern is found out, then we prepare trading account and profit and loss account. And if we find out if we prepare the final account of a non-trading concern, then we prepare income and expenditure account. Okay, that is outside our scope right now. Right now I am in a particular track. In that track I have completed journal, I have completed ledger, I have completed trial balance. Now from this trial balance has given us a picture of a good number of ledger balances. With the help of these balances, I will find out the profit. Okay, net profit. The net profit, how it is found out? Well, there are two segments of profit and loss account, including final account. One is that is known as trading account. Trading account gives us the gross profit. How do we get the gross profit? Total sales, net minus deduction, minus return, that is net sales, and we add the closing stock. And here, on the debit side, opening stock, purchase, net purchase, purchase less return, then all the purchase related expenses. Manufacturing production related expenses. So it gives us the difference, gives us the result, and that is gross profit. From the gross profit, what do? We deduct administrative expenses, we deduct selling expenses, and we get the trading profit originally trading profit. To that trading profit, we should add financial gains, and we should deduct financial loss. And thereby you get the net profit or net profit of organization. So this is the results which we can get out of what? Out of all the transactions I have effected. Clear? So far as I have already discussed a lot. Now today I am taking up some additional issues, and that is known as adjustments. That is the most important part, friend. Please take it into mind. Every day we are adding something in our discussion. I am not at all interested to to go on repeating the same thing in my Insta and in my Facebook. I would like to give something new. Today, my basic concern is some adjustments. What is adjustment and what wants adjustments? Now take the example. Friends, my ardent request to each and everyone, if you are seriously interested in studying the accountancy, the subject accountancy or accounting, please be very, very minute with all my presentations. It will help you and have a continuity in thought. As accounting is a continuous process, an organization is a continuing concern, so please do have the continuing thought, continuous involvement in my materials I am giving through my Insta or my Facebook. Now, take an example. During this period, I have paid wages of rupees 50,000. Clear? But a part of wages has not been paid. Say 5,000 is yet to be paid. How much I have paid? Friends, please take care of this one. I have paid 50,000 wages. Because today I am much more interested with this part, friends, this part, adjustments. That is why I am discussing all this. 50,000 is the total wages that I have paid, but I have not paid the wages of rupees 5,000, which is related to this period. Yesterday I told you that it is the matching cost against revenue. The process of preparation of final account is nothing but matching the cost against revenue. The revenue is through sales and costs are others. If you want to match the cost to revenue, we consider the revenue during a particular period. Understood? We are preparing the account. What we write? We are writing trading account for the year ended. That means we must consider all the incomes, all the expenses during this particular period. Clear? Now think, I have paid rupees 50,000 this year, but I have not paid rupees 5,000, which is related to that year. What does it mean? What is the total wages this year? This year total wages has got two dimensions. One is paid and the other one 5,000 is not paid. So it is total 55,000 wages. Yes? So our total wages is 55,000, mind it. So how much wages I have paid? I have paid 50,000. Very good. What was the journal entry? I am writing over here. What was the journal entry? I am making the adjustment. It is also in journal. Although it should have been taken on some later date, but today I am just letting you know all this. The wages I have paid. What is the journal? Wages account debit to? Yes. 50,000. Clear? But another part, 5,000 wages has not been paid. Why not? Do you know? When it impractically, what happens? What is our time period spent? Time frame is 30th June 2018. But there is a time lapse of wages. Wages is always paid after 7 days or 5 days or 15 days after completion of the year. So a part of the wages has not been paid, although it is due. So it is the expenditure of this year, but I have not paid that. Clear? That is known as outstanding expenses. So it is the expense for generating the income. So for generating sales, I have got the service of those people who have not been paid. Are you getting me? So for earning this amount, I have paid wages. I have taken the wrong amount, 5,000. And our due amount is 500. So the wages has been paid 500. But I have not paid 5,000 already paid. I have not paid 500. What does it mean? What is the total amount of wages? The total amount of wages is 5,500. Clear? But I have paid only 50,000. So that 5,000 wages is also wages expense account debit and outstanding wages credit. Outstanding wages 500 credit. Clear? Like all expenses are debit. I have already told you. It has been repeatedly done. So wages is an expense. So wages has been paid. Wages account debit. Cash account paid. But when it is not paid, but it is due, wages is expenditure, it is due, and outstanding wages, 500 credit. Now, if you may mention the name of the person to whom it is due, clear? Now, what that would be the treatment in this? I am coming to that part. Just you see, and here I have given you some information of a trial balance. The trial balance is agreeing. The trial balance is agreeing at an amount of this 89,000. Both debit side 89,000, credit side 89,000. Clear? And what are the items included? Salary expense debit 3,300. Advertisement 1,400. Bad debt 3,500. Stock, that is opening stock 5,000. Furniture 20,000. Capital and drawing, right? Therefore, you see, in one line it is written, capital and drawing. You know, capital is a credit balance. So, 40,100 is the capital, and it is drawing, that is 9,500. So, as you go on generating more and more knowledge, you will learn all these things. Capital and drawing, in one line. Capital, I have already told you, drawing is the negative capital. Okay, drawing is the negative capital. Amount invested is capital. Bank account, cash account debit to capital. Amount withdrawn, drawing account debit to cash. Okay, so drawing is debited, so it is 9,500 drawing and capital 40,100. Then wages 1,800. Purchase and sales. Purchase here and sales. Purchase is debit 20,000 purchase and sales 38,700. Debtors and painters. Debtors always debit, I have told you. Sold goods to Pachu. Pachu account debit to sales. Okay, Pachu is key. Pachu is a debtor. So, debtor account debit to sales. Whenever I am purchasing goods from X, purchase account debit to X. So, X is my creditor. Creditor always credit, debtors always debit. I have already told you this. So, 9,000 debtors, 5,000 creditors. Cash account 3,200. Then, our 10% interest on loan, interest on loan from SBI, 4,000. Okay. Taken on 1st July 2017, I will come to this part a bit later on, okay? What difference? More analysis. Allowing interest alone. That's a commission. Miscellaneous expenses. Annual fire insurance. The premium is paid on this. So it is another important part. And provision for doubtful it will also be taken into account separately. Clear? So this is the trial balance. Now you have been asked to prepare a trading account. Friends, you know how to prepare a trading account. You have learned a lot. You have attended a good number of classes. Now I have prepared the trading account. Now, what are the items that would come to the trading account? First of all, you see that the materials that would come to the trading account are what? That is, salary will go. Just I am ready. You know, salary where it go? Salary is then as administrative expenses. It will go to profit and loss account. Advertisement, selling expenses will go to profit and loss account. Bad debt, financial loss will go to profit and loss account. You see that the solution is given. Okay, as this it is so in the solution it has already been given. Furniture is an asset. Okay, furniture will come in the asset side of the balance sheet. As I have already told you, balance sheet is a statement of what? Assets and liabilities. Our conventional money issue is that we write the left hand right hand side assets and the left hand side liabilities. So, furniture is an asset and it has been stated over here, I think. How much? In our balance sheet?
20,000.
Furniture 20,000. Right. Achha, then capital and drawing. Capital will come over here and drawing will be deducted from capital. Because you invested 40,100, but out of that you have taken back 9,500. So, it would be deducted. So, capital less drawing. Then wages is basically the production and purchase related expenses. It will come to the profit and loss account. purchase on the debit side of the treasury account, sales credit side of the treasury account. Debtor asset, it will come on the asset side. Here it is. Then creditors liability, there. Here, creditors. Cash asset, debit. The asset side. Loan, your liability, it will be over here. It is liability, credit. Liability. Interest on one, I will take it into separately. Commission is an expenses, will go to profit and loss account. Miscellaneous expenses is also administrative expenses, will go to profit and loss account. And annual fire insurance premium is an expenses. Expense, it will come in the debit side of the profit and loss account. Then provision for doubtful debt, I will come to that. Okay, so these are the items I have already given. Okay, now see. Now I am coming to the profit and trading account part. In the trading account, certainly, friends, you have done a lot of things. Opening stock will come in the trading account. So opening stock, how much? 5,000. Okay, then we have purchase of rupees 28,000 and also return. Here, I have shown you some return, okay. Returns. Two returns are here. One in the debit side 2,000, credit side 1,000. Credit side return is purchase return and debit side return is sales return. Okay. So total purchase is how much? Total purchase 20,000, less return 1,000. It is 27,000. Clear. Now sales. Sales it is 38,700 and the return is 22,000. So 36,700. Then wages 1,800. What is 1800 is given over here. Now, here it is stated, outstanding wages 1000. Outstanding wages 1000. So, sorry. Outstanding wages 1000. What it would be? I have already told you, say, in general, it is wages how much? Wages 1800. So 1800 you have paid already this year. And how much outstanding? 100 is outstanding. So now see, wages 1800 you have paid and outstanding how much? 100. So this outstanding has been added because outstanding expense means the expense will be enhanced. Okay. Now see, there are two implications of this statement. First of all, outstanding wages, it is an expense, so it will be added to the two wages account. Again, this amount is yet to be paid, so it is a liability. The expense already there, but it has not been met. It means you have your due electricity bill for the month of November. Okay, electricity account debit to outstanding electricity bill. So it will be your liability. So it has been put on the liability side. Outstanding wages rupees 1,100. Clear? I think I have cleared the issue. Then from closing stock. Here closing stock is given. Closing stock is that amount of goods which are in the house, which are in the stock, which are in the business organization but yet to be utilized. Okay, this stock is included in what? This stock is included in purchase. Clear? Yes, this thing I have already told you. You had opening stock, say you have opening stock of fan 20 and you have purchased fan of 100. So what is the total amount of balance? You have 120. But out of the 30 fans are yet to be sold, so that is in your stock. So how much? The total opening stock 20,000, purchase 100, less in stock. How much? So that is 90. 90 I have sold. So in the sales, in these sales, which are included? Only the 90 included, okay? But the remaining part is our stock. So if you may deduct it from here, opening stock at purchase less closing stock. That statement I show you in some other classes. Okay. Instead of doing that, you may do it opening stock over here, purchase over here, and closing stock over there. Now this closing stock we have not made it accounted duly, so that closing stock is that we have to make originally we have to pass an entry. What is the entry? Closing stock account debit to purchase or closing stock account debit to trading account. That is the adjustment entry. Okay. So closing stock account debit to trading account. Now take it. Journal is closing stock account debit to trading account. So it will come in the debit side, in the credit side of the trading account. Clear? This credit side in the trading account. Okay. And it is the balance item. So it will go to the balance sheet. In the balance sheet, it is debit. So it is in the debit side of the balance sheet. Clear? And this is very, very important thing. Most of the students, of commerce and economics, they even make this wrong. How? If they are asked to answer, how the closing stock to be accounted for? The closing stock is better accounted for purchase account debit, purchase account credit to closing stock. That is the best way. And if you cannot do that, then it would be closing stock account debit to purchase. To trading account. And what I have done? So if I make the journal, closing stock account debit to purchase, then closing stock should be deducted from here. Okay? And it will come to the asset side of the balance sheet. But if I do not, then closing stock account debit to trading account, then it will come on the face of the trading account and it will divide the balance and it will go to the balance sheet. Okay? So these are the two items I have already discussed. Please bear it into mind, and if you get any problem, contact me. I will give you further discussion. But here, for the purpose of these offline classes, online class, I think that is sufficient for help to you. Just go on visiting this part repeatedly to get your doubts clear, if any. If you cannot get, then contact me. Then come to the then we have got the gross profit, okay? The gross profit is 12,800. And from this gross profit will be transferred to the trading profit and loss account. So this is 12,800, that is gross profit. Now from that part, what do you have to do? Deduct, I have already told you. Salary, advertisement, bad debt, all these are written over here. And then commission, it is also written. Miscellaneous expenses, also written. Okay, so it is salary. So now again in salaries, I have to say something. Salary, how much I have paid? I have paid salary 3,300. And here is the outstanding salary is 500. So same fallacy, same argument. So if salary is an expense, so it has already been paid how much? I have paid 3,300. So a salaries account debit to cash 3,300. Clear? But I have not yet paid how much? I have not yet paid 500. So 500 is due. Good. What it should be? It should be salaries account debit to outstanding salaries. So this 500 will be added to salary, and this 500 is outstanding liability. So it will come in the liability side of the balance sheet. So in the liability side of the balance sheet, I have written outstanding wages 100, salaries 500. That's because this will be 1600 is to be paid to the parties concerned. Okay. So these are liability. I think I have cleared the doubt. Now come to this part. All these are regular. So salary is gone. Salary is gone, advertisement, bad debt, interest on loan. Now you see, 10% interest on loan, how much? 4,000. Taken on which date? 1st July 2017. And what is our period of accounting? Our period of accounting is 1st July 2017 to 30th June 2018. So this is our period, okay? This is our accounting period. So we are making the account for a period of 12 months. The month is ending on 30th July 2018. And the period has got started on 1st of July 2017. I have taken a loan on 1st July 2017. At what interest? At the 10% interest. the what is the loan amount? The loan amount is 44,000. So what should be the interest? The interest is only 400. Okay. So I have to pay 400. But how much I have paid? I have paid only 100. Clear? So the journal is again that reason. Okay. Journal is interest on loan account debit to bank. How much? 100. Okay. But how much I have to pay? I should have paid interest on loan of rupees 400. Okay. But I have paid how much? I have paid only 300. So that, 100. That is 300 is my outstanding interest on loan. Okay. Same reason. Same. Interest on loan account debit to outstanding interest on loan. And that outstanding interest on loan is my liability, 300. And it is also my expense for this year. So it has been added to interest loan. So loan is amount paid of 100 and outstanding 300. So in total interest I have shown, because I am concerned with the matching cost against revenue. So original cost is 400, but I have paid only, it is 400, but I have paid only 100. So 300 is due. So it is an outstanding interest on loan. It is our expense, it is our liability. Why liability? Because amount has not yet been paid. So that is interest on, it has been shown over here, is interest on loan. Clear? So, this is very, very two important issues. Achha. Yellow, then again, what are they? Hello, frozen stock, gone, it is gone. Then come annual fire insurance premium. Annual fire insurance premium. It is how much? 900. 900 I have paid. Just this is a very, very important aspect. Please take care of this issue. I have paid a premium of rupees. How much? 900. What it is written? Annual fire insurance premium. What does it mean? I have paid for 12 months. This 12 months is ending on which day? That's all. The insurance policy has been taken on 1st October 2017. 1st October 2017. So if I have paid the annual premium, so it means I have paid premium for what period? 1-10-2017 September 2018. Clear? I have paid an interest on annual fire insurance premium of 900. The policy has been taken on 1st of October. Clear? So after how many months? Our session starts, our accounting period starts on 1st July. So I have taken up for how many months back? July, August, September. So after 3 months I have taken. I have taken the policy after 3 months, my dear. So how much is related to this year? 3 months have elapsed. After that I have taken the premium. I have taken the policy. And the premium has been paid for 1 year. So that the period is period covered is this. 30th September 2018. But our period is covering on which day? Our last date, we are preparing the final accounts for the period ended 30th 6 2018. Okay, that means 30th 6, that means 3 months. 3 months are yet to be elapsed before the completion of the premium date. Okay, the premium date we have paid extra for 3 months. So the premium paid this amount, the premium paid for the period 1st of July to 30th of September 2018 is our prepaid. Okay, so it is our prepaid premium here. Prepaid annual premium for fire insurance. Okay, so it is asset. Okay, and it should be deducted. How to deduct it? Just you think. I'm taking a simple example. Someone has told you, सर मेरा तनख्वाह तो 10,000 है, मेरा बीवी का तबीयत बहुत खराब है, मेरा बीवी का तबीयत बहुत खराब है सर, 2,000 रुपया एडवांस दीजिए ना. ओके, 2,000 रुपया एडवांस दीजिए ना. तो व्हाट इज दैट? यू हैव प्रिपेयर्ड सैलरी, यू हैव प्रिपेयर्ड दैट सैलरी इन एडवांस. सो द सैलरी शुड बी क्रेडिटेड एंड योर प्रिपेयर्ड सैलरी शुड बी क्रेडिटेड. So any expense which is given earlier, it is your asset. Okay, and any amount which is yet to be paid, that is known as liability. Okay, so annual insurance premium given for 12 months is yet to cover the total period, because another three months in my hand, and that the premium of that part has already been paid. So it is not the expenses of this year. So that amount should be deducted. That is why we have deducted 1/4 of the annual premium. 1/4 of the annual premium has been deducted. What I have done? So annual premium is 900. 1/4, that is 3 months part, has been deducted. And this is our asset. And it has gone to prepaid insurance premium. Clear? Now come to the next part. So one thing I'll let you know, just to think. There are question of prepaid and outstanding. There are the question of prepaid and outstanding. They're very, very important. Just you think it and ask yourself, any expense which has already been due but not paid is your liability. The school fees which is to be paid by you. Okay, say you are supposed to pay 12,000 this year. Okay, so you have paid only 9,000. What does it mean? The fees is there, fees account debit to outstanding fees. Outstanding should be your liability. It should be added. Matching cost against revenue, what I have told you. This year's total fees is 12,000. Although you have paid 9,000, but the 3,000 is due but not paid. Okay, so it is your liability. And now you have paid, you are very generous, you are very, very, as a good follower of the principle of Bharana Chakravarti Memorial School, your guardian said, sir, I am interested to pay extra amount for the compensation. Okay, how much you do give? Sir, aapko paas pe paisa nahi hai, chaliye hum 5,000 rupees aage sab de rahe. So it is not, he has paid 15,000 or 19,000, but that 19,000, out of that 5,000 is not of this period, right? So you have prepaid, okay? So that is the advance to the school, okay? That is the advance to the school. So the fees should be reduced. Fees account credit and advance fee will be deducted, okay? The advance fee, any expense, advance paid is an asset and outstanding is liability. Just exactly the reverse. Any income. Which is paid in advance, received in advance is a liability, and paid in advance is a liability, and outstanding is income. Income outstanding. My income outstanding, what is that? It is my asset. Income, any income prepaid, that is my liability. Just to think, I have to receive fees. Say, consider it. I have to receive fees 20,000, but I have received 24,000. Now what is happening? I have received, what is that? Cash account debit 24,000 to fees. Okay, but it relates to what? It's 4,000 is yet to be due. Okay, is yet to be due. It is your liability. Now, if you are, if I have received only 18,000, okay, so it is cash account debit to fees, how much? 18,000, okay. Now I have to get the another fees, so outstanding fees, but that is outstanding income account debit to fees. Fees, 2,000, so it is my income, it is my asset. Clear? Outstanding fees, outstanding expense, liability, advance expense is an asset. It reverse. Advance fee is your liability and outstanding fee is your asset. Clear? Now it is gone, outstanding prepaid. Now value of closing stock, I think you have cleared. Huh? I have cleared. Then comes the question of depreciation. What is depreciation? Yesterday I told you, depreciation is the loss in the value of assets due to two reasons. One is wear and tear, that is using. As you go on using a particular property or asset, it goes on reducing in terms of its strength, in terms of its performance and all this. And it's, and as a result of the passage of time, the value of the assets also may diminish. And that is a reduction in cost due to wear and tear and passage of time. So depreciation is always, whatever it may be, depreciation reduces the value of the asset. Okay? Now, our furniture is how much? Our furniture is 20,000. It has been depreciated by 10%. That means I have decided that this furniture, the value of the furniture has gone down by 10%. So what would be the value? The 20%, 20,000 is our asset. 10% reduced. So what would be the closing value? That is furniture 20,000 less depreciation 2,000. So at the back end of the year, I am getting the furniture of rupees 18,000. And this is 2,000 is a loss. What is the journal entry? Therefore, all losses are debit. So depreciation account debit to asset. I told you in many occasions all assets are debit. Okay. Now the asset value is being reduced. So asset account will be credited. And for what reason? For depreciation. So depreciation account debit to asset. So what would be the treatment in case of current account? In the balance sheet, the depreciation value should be deducted from the asset. And it is a loss, so it will come to the profit and loss account. Therefore, depreciation on furniture. Say it is depreciation machinery. Same value. You thought, say you have purchased, I am giving you a specific example. You have purchased a machinery. You have thought on 1-7-2017, you have purchased a machinery of 50,000. And you have decided that this machine will give me service for coming 10 years. Okay, then it is the life of the machine for 10 years. So what will be the loss of the machine? So today the value of machine is 50,000. After 10 years it will get a value of 0. So now you have to come down to 0 value during the last 10 years. What does it mean? Every year 5,000 should be deducted as depreciation. So it shall how much? Machinery, when you purchase the machine you got able to cash 50,000. Now, at the end of the year, the machinery, that machinery is there. No loss, no amount has gone. But you are decided that 10%, 5,000 will be reduced. So depreciation account debit to machinery. Clear? And this depreciation, someone, Akash sponsor is thinking, sir, you can say expense was, sir, it's expense nahi hua. Machine to wahi hai, just after accounting, here, I am making the account in this one. This is the matching cost against revenue. What I have told you, all the costs for earning that revenue should be deducted. It may be in cash, it may not be in cash. But and the amount which, practically, depreciation is a very, very long chapter, and the amount which I have deducted from profit, okay, that amount will be kept aside. Because a fund would be made ready, and when a new machine will have to be purchased, that fund will be utilized. There is a long process, but right now for your concern, you know, depreciation is a loss in the value of assets. So is a loss or losses are debit, depreciation account debit, and the value of asset is reducing the asset account debit. Clear? So as a result of depreciation, it is known as adjustment entry. So this depreciation is deducted from the concern asset, and it will be in loss, and it will be shown in profit and loss account. Clear? Then comes another very, very vital part, that is provision for doubtful debt. Provision for doubtful debt or provision for bad debt. What it is? You have affected sales. Say you have affected sales this year. How much? 70,000. Nice. Out of that, 20,000 in cash. Very good. Cash account debit to sales. No problem, no tension. You are happy. If you are interested, you may purchase some ornament for your wife because you have the cash in hand. But why am I telling you? हाँ जी, 70,000 का सेल किए हैं, मेरे को 2,000 का गहना दे रहे हो, 50 को दो, बोले अरे कि नहीं, पैसा नहीं मिलेगा, हाँ, पैसा नहीं के मिला, ओके, तो the amount is yet to receive, it is our credit sales, ओके, so in case of excess, what do we do? I have sold sold goods to Pachu, Pachu to sales. Hundred to sales, ठीक है, avoid to sales, visa to sales, submit to sales, very good. Okay, so these are the different debtor. So all are debtor. Debtor is one who is purchasing goods from you. Clear? Are you sure that all debtors are very good and they will pay them, make them out? सानी सुनित सानी का बात याद नहीं है? 30,000 रुपया का माल खरीद करके 10,000 देकर भाग गया. And every possibility is there. Circuit will be. Sir, आप किसको किसको सोचे हैं जो पैसा नहीं देगा? Circuit number one. Phone suit number two. हाँ, ये तो सुना. Okay. Then. Okay, ना मैं बोला करता हूँ. वो भी ऐसा माल नहीं देने वाला है. Sagni study, sir, आप कैसे सोच रहे हैं? मैं दूंगा. हम ऐसे इंटरव्यू है, मेरा पापा बहुत अच्छे सर, 50,000 दे देंगे. ठीक है, दे भी देंगे, नहीं भी दे देंगे, है ना? फोन सो व्हेनेवर आई एम आस्किंग, व्हेनेवर ही हैज नॉट पेड, व्हेनेवर आई हैव सीन दैट ही हैज नॉट पेड इज द मोर आई वेंट टू हिज हाउस. लो दोनों ये लो तब. अरे सर, किसको ढूंढ रहे हैं? हम फोन सो को. अरे फोन सो ने कब के ये घर छोड़ के चले गए सर यूपी में? तो दया. This is the tension. Now, हमको सोच, मैं सोची थी जो 50,000 मिलेगा, 50,000 तो नहीं मिल रहा है, हम सोचे थे वो पैसा लेकर हम बीवी को गहना खरीद कर देंगे. तो ये बीवी के साथ झगड़ा हो गया, बीवी डिवोर्स हो जाएगा, क्या करेंगे? बीवी होने छोड़ेंगे तो बहुत प्रॉब्लम हो जाएगा. सो आई हैव टू टेक प्रिपेयर सम प्रिकॉशन बिफोर हैंड. व्हाट वुड आई डू? एवरी ईयर at the flagging, at the while I am preparing final accounts, I will assess the status of the debtors. कौन कैसा है, more or less some track record and all this. You are sure, they say, you are thinking that 90% debtors are fine, they must give. But 10% debtors are there who may give or may not give. वो भाग भी जा सकता है, नहीं भाग सकता है. तो भाई एक काम करो, पहले से प्रॉफिट से पैसा को घटा के रखो, बाद में देखा जाएगा. ठीक है, तो दैट इज व्हाई ए पार्ट ऑफ द प्रॉफिट इज केप्ट असाइड इन एंटीसिपेशन टू फॉर एंटीसिपेशन ऑफ दैट देयर आर दे मे बी द पेमेंट दे मे नॉट मेक द पेमेंट दे आर डाउटफुल डेट्स. ओके, सो क्लीन डेट्स, द डेट्स देयर आर 90% क्लीन डेट, 10% डेट्स आर डाउटफुल, दे भी सकते हैं, नहीं भी दे सकता है. तो फॉर दैट व्हाट वी डू, ए कीप ए पार्ट ऑफ आवर प्रॉफिट फ्रॉम केप्ट असाइड, वी कीप ए पार्ट ऑफ आवर प्रॉफिट असाइड, ओके, टू मीट एनी इवेंचुअलिटीज दैट मे ऑकर इन द नियर फ्यूचर. ओके, सो ए पार्ट ऑफ द प्रॉफिट इन आवर केस व्हाट हैज बीन डन, क्रिएट ए प्रोविजन फॉर डाउटफुल डेट. What is the amount of debtor? The amount of debtor is 9,000. So 5% means 450. 450 may not be received. So a part of it, this part has been deducted from profit and loss account. Okay, so in the profit and loss account it is debited. Clear? Understood? And this balance is maintained in the coming year. Okay, just like last year also we made a provision for doubtful debt, 200. Clear? And I think that amount has been received. So I have neutralized it. What is the journal entry I am passing? You see. So please take care. In case of depreciation, what I have done? Depreciation account debit to furniture. Because the value of the furniture is being reduced. But provision for bad debt does not mean, provision for doubtful debt does not mean that the debtors are reducing. Okay? So we are making the provision and all provisions are credit. Provision for doubtful debt or bad debt. Okay, credit. And it is profit and loss account debt. Oh, a separate ledger account is prepared. This is known as adjustment entries with regards to provision for bad debt. So it is in the case of in profit and loss account debit to provision for doubtful debt. Okay? And then this amount it has been deducted from the debtors. Okay? Clear? Although it should have not been deducted to debtors, it should have been kept aside anyway. For initial practice, you do that. And the last year, the provision for doubtful debt, which we created last year, has been neutralized and it has been put in the credit side. Okay? So last year, that your provision had, that amount has been neutralized and this year provision has been taken. Okay? Thus, we have got a gross profit of this much and it has been carried out over here, brought down, and we have got a net loss. Net loss, okay. This is net loss, unfortunate business it is. So this net loss, here we have done, what we have done? Capital, we add net profit, and net, we also add net loss. Net loss is minus, okay. And drawing. So we have got this amount, loan, credit card, outstanding. So we have got a total balance sheet of rupees 39,975. Clear? So friends, so this is the road. It's a very long process, lengthy process. Tomorrow also I will take up this type of one account, one problem, and after that I will conclude it this one. Okay? And we will give you some literary materials for the part what really into accounting process. Thank you very much. Stay tuned with us.